What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Taylor Cut Tutorial. In today's episode, we're gonna get into a frequently asked question, how I edit my travel photos. I've been lucky enough to make photography and videography my full-time career for nearly 10 years now. I first started doing films and photos when I was in high school. My freshman year, I took video production as an elective, and my teacher taught me how to use Adobe Premiere Pro. Before taking that class, I literally had no idea it was even possible for one person to make a video. Literally from that moment on, every opportunity I got, whether it was just hanging out with my friends or a homework assignment, I was making videos. Learning how to edit photos and videos literally changed my life forever. I always wanted to tell stories, but I didn't know it was possible until I took that class. I continue to make photos and videos since graduating high school, and I've been lucky enough to travel the world and do what I love day in and day out. I started just making fun little music videos and short films with my friends, and it's crazy to think that that passion has led me to being able to travel around the world doing what I love. I've been able to travel the world and make videos for artists such as Usher, Justin Bieber, Martin Garrix, Jennifer Lopez, and the Chainsmokers. It's crazy to think of what can happen when you just have the passion and the belief that you can do it. Part of the reasons why I love making these tutorials is because I read your guys' comments and feedback, and it's amazing to hear how some of you have the exact same passions that I do. Whether you want to make photo and video your full-time career, or you just want to learn how to edit your spring break and travel photos better, here are some tips on how to do that. The first thing you're going to need to know is what settings to shoot on your camera. When shooting on my DSLR, I make sure to always shoot in RAW or CR2 format. This you can do by going into your camera settings. Most high-end DSLRs have the option of doing JPEG or RAW. I always select RAW or CR2 because that means that there's the least amount of compression going on within the camera. This means when you go to edit your photos, you have the most amount of information possible. With RAW, you get a lot more flexibility with what you can do with the coloring, and what you can do to manipulate the image is pretty limitless. So once you're done selecting the right format on your camera, the next thing you're going to need to do is download the correct editing software on your computer. For me, I use the Adobe Creative Cloud in order to edit all my photos and my videos. With the Adobe Creative Cloud, you pay a monthly fee in order to download whatever editing programs you need. For me, this is great because I have all of Adobe's products. I use Adobe Premiere and After Effects when editing my videos, and then I use Adobe Lightroom and Photoshop when editing my photos. If you don't have already, I'll include in the description a link in order to get the Adobe Creative Cloud, and then you could choose which plan works best for you. So for this tutorial, we're gonna get into Adobe Lightroom and how I use it to edit all my travel photos. All right, let's go into the computer now. I'll show you how to connect the memory card to the computer, how to import your photos into Lightroom, and then how to do all the editing.
Okay, so first thing you're gonna wanna do is make sure that your photos are properly imported either onto your computer or on a hard drive. I keep all of my photos and videos on an external hard drive because I don't want it taking up too much memory on my computer. These are my external hard drives right here. And for the sake of this tutorial, I made a special folder called Photos for Tutorial, and I imported 5 raw files that we're gonna be editing today. Now, so just that you can see, this is where the Adobe Creative Cloud icon is within your computer. Right here, the list of applications that I have installed. So like I mentioned before, I have Photoshop and Lightroom for photo, and Premiere Pro and After Effects for video. Now you could either open Adobe Lightroom from this drop-down menu here, or you could have the icon in your icon bar and select it. Since this drop-down menu is already open, let's just go to Lightroom and select open. And here is Adobe Lightroom. Okay, so first thing I'm gonna wanna do is import the photos. So I'm gonna go down to the left-hand corner here, select import. Now there's some different options up here when it comes to importing photos. I like to do add. So what this does is add the photos into Adobe Lightroom without moving them on your physical hard drive. So I'm gonna hit select source. Now this is a list of previously imported folders. Since the photos we're importing is from a new destination, I'm gonna select other source. I'm gonna select the hard drive that the folder saved on. And then I'm gonna select photos for tutorial because that's where my photos are. I hit choose. And now it's showing me a little preview of the photos that are within the folder. They are all selected, so there's nothing I need to change. And then I'm gonna select import. As you can see, it says import files at their current location, which is what I mentioned before. It is not moving the photos on the hard drive. And now that the status bar is gone, the photos are imported into my Adobe Lightroom. So this is the library tab, so it's showing me the photos that are currently in my library. And since previous import is selected right here, it's only showing me the photos that I just imported. If I wanted to, I could select all photographs and it will show me all the photos that I've ever imported into Adobe Lightroom. But for the sake of this tutorial, we're just gonna worry about these 5 photos here. So now I wanna go ahead and color them. All I need to do for that is select the develop tab. And then it brings me into this develop window. So first thing I do is select a preset here under the list of user presets. Now these are all customized presets that I have created from the past of editing photos before. If you don't have your own list of user presets, it's okay. I can still show you how to adjust your photo using these slider tabs here. Or if you'd like to use my specific user presets, I will include in the description a link to download my presets. So for this particular photo, I'm going to select a preset called Pismo. Now this is the look it gives after applying the preset. So it's a pretty good starting point, however it is very dark. So let's go over to the right side here and start adjusting some of these sliders. Just so I can familiarize a lot of you with what each slider and section does, I'm going to go in order. Right here is the white balance. I'm going to leave the white balance as shot because I did a pretty good job of adjusting the white balance within the camera. If however you think the white balance is off, and what white balance means is essentially the color temperature of your photo, there are different ways to adjust it. You can select auto, which as you can see makes it a little bit warmer. You can go to daylight, which is, as you can see makes the sky a little bit bluer because it adjusts the color temperature. And there's even a white balance selector tool, which you can select, and if there is something that you think is true white within the photo, for example, these clouds, you can click on it, and it'll adjust the white temperature based on that. For this photo, I'm gonna leave the white balance as shot. Now, like I mentioned, it is pretty dark, but there are a bunch of different ways how I can brighten it up. So what you can do is go over to the exposure tab and adjust that to the right, and by increasing that, what it does is it brings up the brightness of everything within the photo. That means it brings up the highlights, the shadows, the whites, the blacks. For this photo, however, I'm going to hit Command-Z and go back to where we were, and I'm going to customize it rather than just bringing up the exposure entirely. So I'm going to go over to Highlights, and if you don't know, highlights are the bright areas within the photo. And as you can see, it's all the way down, but I'm going to start dragging that to the right. So as you can see, what it's mainly adjusting are the clouds and the plane. So I'm going to bring that up almost towards the middle because I think that looks pretty good. So the next slider bar is Shadows. What the shadows are, if you didn't guess, is essentially the dark shadow portions. So if I adjust shadows, that's just going to adjust the dark areas. So as I start bringing that to the right, as you can see, I'm gaining more detail on the jacket, my pants, and the shadows within the grass. So I'm going to leave it just about there because that's pretty good. Next, you can play with whites if you want to, which is essentially everything that's white within the photo. I'm going to leave that just about as is because I think it's pretty good. And lastly is the black slider. I'm gonna leave blacks basically where it is because I still like having some contrast within the photo. Next, what I like to do before getting any lower and messing with a specific color is I'm gonna crop in on this photo. Since I know the end result for this photo is gonna be to send to my phone and upload to my different social media platforms, I'm gonna crop it in to match the dimensions which works best for posting to social media. So I'm gonna select this crop tool here. Under aspect, instead of original, I'm gonna go down to enter custom. And I'm gonna do aspect ratio of 5:4. I'm gonna hit okay. And as you can see, it crops the top and bottom a little bit. And then you can go ahead and click and adjust it up and down depending on where you think looks best. Right about here, I think looks good. As you can see, it has this grid system. You can use that in order to line up key parts of the photo. And then I'm gonna select done. So this is what the photo is gonna look like when you send it to your phone. And the size is also now customized in order to post to social media. Now the photo is looking pretty good. I think it's almost ready to export, but a lot of the work was done within the actual preset, so I'm going to show you how I got it to look the way it does. So we're going to go ahead and scroll down to the color tab here, and as you can see, it has all the different colors, red, orange, yellow, green. So there are a couple things within the color that I like to do in order to give it my tailor cut look. So the main color I want to work with right now is yellow, so I'm going to select the yellow tab, and as you can see, the different options you have to adjust are hue, saturation, and luminance. For hue, if you go ahead and drag the slider to the left, as you can see, it starts to change all the yellow within the photo. All the way to the left is almost a red color, and all the way to the right is a bright green color. So you can adjust based on your preference. I like to have it somewhere around -50 because it gives it this nice earthy tone. Next, you can play with the saturation here. Drag it all the way to the left and it desaturates it to black and white. Bring it all the way to the right and it super saturates it. For me, I think a good balance is about +16. It's still pretty colorful, but not too saturated where it looks artificial. And lastly is luminance, which is the brightness of the color. Bring it to the left and it darkens it. Bring it to the right and it brightens it up. Now, what's nice about making these adjustments within the color tab here is you're isolating and only making the adjustments to the specific color. For this, I want to keep it pretty moody and earthy, so I'm going to make the luminance about -59. Now I'm loving the colors and tones in this right now, so I think it's about ready to export. And once you think the photo is done, the way to export it back to your computer or hard drive is to go to File, Export. Next, select the specific folder of where you want to send it to. I'm just going to go ahead and select Choose Desktop because my desktop is pretty neat, so it's easy for me to locate it there. Hit Choose. File name I'm going to leave as is, so it's not going to rename, it's just going to add a dash one, so that way you know it's the first export of this particular file that you're doing. Next, scroll down, and the most important area is file settings. For file format, I'm going to make sure it's a JPEG, so that way it's not exporting as a RAW or a CR2 file. JPEG is a super friendly format. For quality, I'm going to make it 100, so that way it's the highest quality possible. And for color space, I'm going to select Adobe RGB. Finally, I'm going to select export, and as you can see up here in the status bar, it is currently exporting the file to my computer. All right, so let's go ahead and mess with another photo here. So I'm going to select this photo. So this photo I just recently uploaded to my social media, so let's go ahead and show you how I got the look. First step again is selecting a preset. I'm going to select one of my user presets, and for this one I'm going to select Dunes. Now I love the coloring this one. As you can see, it's very filmic and very earthy. I love the color tones. Now it's looking pretty good, but there are some adjustments I want to make in order to make it the best version possible for my social media. So what I'm going to want to do is go ahead and crop in again. So crop tool. For aspect, I'm going to select custom. Again, we're going to go to 5x4, select OK. And for me personally, I think this line here is slightly on a slant. So when I go and hover my mouse over the right hand side here, it gives me the option. And I'm going to go ahead and rotate it a little bit to the left. Now I'm going to hit done. And that's looking pretty good, but personally for me, for my social media, I think I'm a little bit too far away. So what I'm gonna do is just crop in a little bit more. I'm gonna select the crop tool one more time, and I'm just gonna keep lowering this. And what's nice right now is since constrain to image is selected, it's gonna keep that aspect ratio of 5x4, so you don't have to worry. It's still gonna be the right format for your social media. I'm just gonna lower it until the crop that I think looks good. Raise it up a bit here. And I'm gonna position it right about there. I'm gonna hit done. Now I think that's looking a lot better. You still get the beautiful landscape, but it is punched in enough now when you upload it to social media. The subject, which is me, is still very present within the photo. There are a couple of other great tricks you can use within Adobe Lightroom to really make sure you're getting the most out of your photo. Another neat trick I love doing is if you scroll all the way to the bottom here, under lens correction here, I love messing with the distortion. Make sure constrained crop is selected, that way the aspect stays the same. And you could either drag it to the right to make it seem like you are farther away, or drag it to the left to make it seem like you're closer. For me, it is very important to have a lot of depth in my photo, so with the 20, it makes it seem like I'm far away. This is in the foreground. It really adds a lot more depth and layers to it. And another trick I love to do in order to add a dreamlike effect to my photos is go and select the radial filter. So for this particular radial filter, I'm gonna make sure clarity is selected. And for this particular effect I like doing, I'm gonna make my clarity at about minus 50. So now with this radial filter, I can go ahead and draw a little circle around me and place it basically so I'm in the middle. And what it's now doing, it's keeping me and this portion of the photo intact, but for the rest of the photo, it's adding a minus 51 clarity. So essentially it's adding almost a haze to the photo. Why I like doing this is because now your attention is focused on me, which is the subject, but it also adds this really cool dreamlike feel to your photo. It's almost adding a blurriness or a haze to it. I'm gonna go ahead and toggle between the on and off of the radial filter so you can see the difference. This is with it off, as you can see everything is really sharp, and with it on, adds this really nice dreamlike feel to it. So I'm gonna go ahead and select done. And now I think the photo is ready to export. What's nice now is since we already exported a photo with the settings that we want, we don't have to then go file, export all over again. We could just go to file, export with previous, and there are no settings that we need to change. Now it's exporting my file to the desktop with all the same settings that we selected before. Now for this particular Tailor Cut Sunday, I wanted to put together a very special edit to say thank you for all of the love and support that I've gotten over this past year. Go ahead, check it out, and let me know what you think. It is time for a Tailor Cut film.
I would always wonder why birds would stay in the same place when they could fly anywhere in the world. Then one day, I asked myself the same question. Thank you. flash before your eyes. Make sure it's worth watching.
All right, everyone, I hope you found this tutorial helpful. If you did, please leave this video a thumbs up. I'm posting a new video every single Sunday, so if you aren't already, make sure to click and subscribe to the channel. If there are any other topics you want to see me cover, just mention in the comment sections below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, I'll see you next Taylor Cut Sunday.